Hello everyone, my name is Auro and welcome to the 6th Devlog of my second game that was recently bestowed with the name Chambers of Devious Design. In this Devlog, I will be creating a simple AI and adding some visual information to my rooms. Okay, let's go. To start off this week, I decided to add some probabilities to my rune types and my room shapes. By doing this, I can have some of the rune types and shapes be more rare than others. I did this with a raffle ticket method. I don't know if it's actually called by that name, but I think it's a pretty descriptive name. So, each of my rune types have a specific number assigned to them that represents the number of raffle tickets they have. When I am creating a new random room, each rune type gets assigned a unique number range that is as big as the number of tickets they have. I then generate a random number between 1 and the total number of tickets. A lucky winner is then chosen based on whose range that chosen number falls into, and the new room will be set as a room of that type. I then do the same for the different room shapes the room type can have. I think it's a pretty neat way to do it, since this way I can easily add new room types to the calculation without having to adjust the code at all. After this, I decided to start working on a simple AI so I can have someone to play with. It's not really necessary at this point, but I thought adding at least a simple version of an AI would help me design my code so that it's relatively universal for both human players and AI players. This way, I hope I can avoid having two versions for every method. Okay, I got the first version now. Let's see how it works. Wait, hey, stop that. I haven't taught you how to cheat just yet. Until then, you need to play fair. Unbelievable. No manners at all. Okay, I've got a fix in place. Hey, no, you can't do that either. You can't move the blocks after they are placed. Looks like I'll need to be careful with this one. It's trying to find all the loopholes. Okay, that's better. Keep playing nicely. The AI is following the placement rules, but at the moment, it's still just randomly choosing the blocks and randomly deciding where to place them. As I'm further into development, I will give it a bit more intelligence, so it will actually try to choose the right blocks and the right locations. One challenge I will have with the AI is that every time a block is moved, I need to wait for the physics to update before doing anything impactful with the code. For the slow human, this isn't that big of an issue, but as the AI is as fast as the game itself, I need to keep slowing it down at almost every turn. I don't think this will be a big problem, but it will definitely require some additional consideration when designing the AI code. Overall, I think turning the AI into a competent and challenging opponent for the player will be one of the major challenges with my game. But on the other hand, I do enjoy designing an AI, so I'm looking forward to it already. After a few adjustments, mainly adding some delays and a glow to signify which room the AI is choosing, it's now an alright playing companion. It can even play with itself. How cute. I could just keep watching them build all day. Maybe at one point I'll go away for an hour or two and see what kind of a monstrosity they come up with. After that, I added a room completion bonus. Currently, I just have a temporary checkmark animation there to highlight when a room gets completed, but it is my intention to later on give the player some type of a completion bonus when this happens. This will likely also be tied to the room type, so each different type will have a unique completion bonus. Next, I decided to start designing some visual elements for displaying information related to the different rooms. My current idea is that I would have an extensive list of information when a room is clicked, and then some quick overview type of information you can access by hovering the mouse over a room. I decided to start with the quick overview information. I was thinking I would include here the name of the room, the point value of the room for scoring, and then add some info about what kinds of rooms this room likes and hates. There's a problem though with the amount of info I want to show compared to how much real estate I have for showing that information. There just isn't enough space. I need to be able to fit all this information in the smallest room I'm going to use, but obviously it still needs to be readable. The room name takes way too much space even with a small font and would likely cause troubles at the latest with localization. So I decided to leave it out of the quick info. It's a good thing I was able to free up some space because I realized I will probably want to also show an upgrade level for the room. My idea is that good adjacent rooms will upgrade the effectiveness of a room, so this will be an important piece of information. I have a bad feeling that showing all of this information in a pleasing package will be a tough challenge. Next, I decided to try showing the info outside the borders of the room. It looks better, but the problem is that I will be wanting to show this information for multiple rooms at the same time. If there are many small rooms near each other, it will cause the info panels to clutter and overlap each other. So I think this is a no-go. Then I thought that if my room types would have a maximum of two rooms they either hate or love, I think I would then be able to fit the details better. While I very much dislike that I need to set limitations to the gameplay because of the visual aspect, in this case I think it might actually be a good thing for the gameplay itself. By limiting the amount of adjacency bonuses per room type, I will reduce complexity that might easily feel unnecessarily tedious to the player. Having up to 6 different adjacency effects for each room type could easily overwhelm the player with information. This seems like the best option so far, so I'm going to go with it for now and see if I come with any better ideas later on. Next, I decided to add some more functionality to the info panels. Now I have a toggle button to show all the infos, and they will also be shown if the mouse is over the available rooms area or if you're tracking a room, so you can get that tactical look when you are about to place a block. But there's just one problem. The info panel looks kind of ugly, I think. One option I have is to dim the whole room when the info panel is shown. It looks a bit better, but I don't really like the idea that so many of the colors would get muted every time I want to show this info. I could also just skip adding any kind of a dimming effect to the room. It might make the info less readable, but I think currently it's probably the best out of all the options so far. I think I'll leave it like that for now and see if I come up with some new ideas as I go on. Do you have some clever ideas in mind for how to show this information? Let me know if you do. I have a feeling that this will actually end up being one of the biggest challenges in the game, design-wise, so any help is appreciated. And that's where I will end this devlog. In the next one, I'll probably keep working on visualizing information and then start adding some gameplay around room scoring and things like that. Maybe I'll even get crazy and add some type of a win condition. Okay, but hey, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.